Whether he's in the spotlight or behind the scenes, our next guest knows how to keep us entertained. His incredible music in Broadway's Beetlejuice was Tony nominated. Now he's taking the stage once again. He's here now. Would you please give a very warm welcome to Eddie Perfect? The new show is called Candide?
Candide.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Is that the right pronunciation?
That is the right pronunciation.
And it's a sort of a bit of opera.
Yeah.
Explain.
So for that, it's a kind of a crossover Broadway opera piece that was written by Leonard Bernstein, the great Leonard Bernstein, who most people would know, wrote the music for West Side Story, but was also an incredible conductor. And he had this vision to create this piece based on Voltaire's novella, which was called Candide.
Yeah.
And it's sort of a bizarre story about a lot of things, philosophy, love, war, death, how are we supposed to live?
And just it's a few themes.
Yeah.
Cycles across continents. It's epic, and the score is going to be played by the Vic Opera Orchestra, a 60-piece orchestra, and most of the singers, myself not included, are opera singers. And we had our first sing through today, and they're extraordinary. I'm like, oh, I think I'm the personality hire. They're amazing.
You're there for good vibes.
I'm there for vibes, guys.
It sounds amazing. It's a bit of a departure from Beetlejuice or Shane Warne the Musical. A lot of people would know you from that. What do you look for in a project when you're picking one?
Well, the things that attracted me to this is, firstly, Leonard Bernstein is a great hero of mine. His composition is extraordinary. It's like if anyone that knows the score to West Side Story, it has all this kind of kinetic, frenetic energy, and he just knows, as a conductor, knows how to corral an orchestra and make it sound as epic as possible. So I loved the music, and I was like, well, I've got to be inside that sound. Secondly, Victorian Opera is an amazing company based here in Victoria, and they put on incredible works and they're great to work for. Dean Bryant is the director. He's one of the best directors in Australia. Ben Northey, the conductor, is one of our greatest conductors. And so I was just like, I just have to be a part of this. I said yes, and now I'm stressing out because it's a lot of work and a lot of lines. And but I love the piece. I'm so excited to do it.
The passion's there, though. So you've got it.
Yeah, I love it. And I think audiences are... It has never had its full treatment in Melbourne before. So for Melbourne audiences, they're going to love it. It's at the Palais. It's just big and it'll be gorgeous.
Musicals seem to be, you know, really in the zeitgeist at the moment. In movie theatres, we've got, you know, Wonka, Mean Girls.
Yeah.
Why do you think they are having such a moment?
Look, I don't think... I think the ability to tell story through song is something that we've had since humans existed. You can get away with a lot in a song. I feel like music brings with it this sort of like an emotional sort of bubbling landscape that people can access immediately. And then the words on top convey nuance and they can either go with the music or against the music. And I think the possibilities of telling stories with music are endless. And Mean Girls is what a great thing to set music to. I think you can be more vile and vicious, you can be more beautiful. Any human thing you can do to a maximum with song. I think you can get away with it.
Eddie, you're working on a musical for the US. It sounds like it could be big. Can you give us any information about it?
Yeah, well, I've been working with a writer, script writer, or what we call them book writers in musical theatre, called Robert Horn, who is a very funny American writer who wrote a musical on Broadway called Shucked, which has been nominated for all the Tonys and is about to be made into a feature film again, another movie musical. And he's extraordinary and very funny. And we're writing a Christmas musical. It's sort of our version of A Christmas Carol. And we're just writing it because we love each other and we came up with a really stupid, funny concept that made us laugh. And we wrote it during the pandemic over Zoom. So it was was one of the things that kept me sane. We just got on our computer and we wrote away, and now it's up to the stage of being workshopped. We've done one workshop and we're about to do more, which is very exciting.
Yes, huge.
Busy as ever. Oh, you can see Eddie in Candide in Melbourne for a limited run next month. Ticket info is on our website. Would you please thank Eddie Perfect?
Yeah. Thank you.